Morning, hello. Oh, you can see me today. I hope all of you are doing good. My background, it's my sister's garden. Okay, this is where I pick some of the things that I need while I cook here. Oh, this is basil, pandan. There's many other leaves that I could use for cooking. Now there's also kuchai somewhere there and mint. Wow, garden, no? A place where we can see growth. Our topic for today is about growing in Christ. Okay, let us open our Bibles to 2 Peter 3:18. Okay, get your Bibles. Let us read together. But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Again, 2 Peter 3:18. But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Have you ever fallen from your bed? It's something I read in the devotion. He couldn't understand why he slept in his bed and the next morning he would be on the floor. So he asked his mom, why? And mom said she will check. Mom observed this boy every night and she discovered why. Because the boy would often read a book or play with his gadgets at the edge of his bed every night. And he stayed there until he finally slept. No, he didn't move in. Now I know, the boy said. And from that time on, he learned to move in and didn't fall again. Like the boy, we will fall if we do not move in. If we stay at the edge, won't we? In our deep slumber, we will forget where we are and we will fall easily. The same thing will happen in our spiritual lives if we do not get in. No? We cannot stay at the edge, at the place where we were when we first know Him. We may be comfortable where we started, but we need to get in, to get closer, to have that deeper relationship with our Master. Okay? In our deep slumber, in our contented prayer life, in our busyness, in our idleness, it is very easy to put Him aside. Yes, we still remember to pray. We ask for so many things in our prayer, don't we? But He just gets the crumbs of our time. Crumbs. See the crumbs? Oh, those that have fallen. Tira-tira. Okay? We grow taller and bigger each year. I am sure when we see each other again, all of you must have grown bigger, except teacher. Just as we grow physically, we should also grow spiritually. There must be a change in us after accepting Jesus into our hearts. Check yourselves. You answer this yourself. Do you try hard not to sin? Are you truly sorry if you have done wrong? Do you try to live like Christ? We can be seated in our classroom or at home listening to our teachers for years now. If nothing is changing in you, if you do not desire to grow closer to Him, if you sin and you don't even feel sorry for your sins, you know, after 10 years, even 20 years of coming to church, you will stay the same, at the edge, you know, where it is so easy to fall. You can be happily contented and say, I am a Christian. I thought, teacher, it is enough to attend Sunday school. I thought it is enough. I can be labeled a Christian and earn my way to heaven one day. This is one of the reasons why Christians, or rather people who go to church, still live a sinful life, a life just like the non-believers. That is why many non-believers do not want to be Christians, because we are not good role models. Going to church, joining activities in church, attending seminars, workshops. These things help us grow spiritually. But what is the condition of our heart? Are you attuned to Him? People don't see things inside us, in our hearts, but God sees inside us, and that is more important for Him. Do you love Him today more than you did when you first know Him? Do you want to learn more about Him? Do you give Him your time? Do you want to serve Him? Or are you contented to be just seated each Sunday? If you truly love someone, you will not just say it or sing it, but you will want to do something for Him. You will not be contented with listening each Sunday. You will desire to do more for Him, to be more intimate, to grow closer to Him by talking to Him more, by learning about His Word, and you want to serve Him with joy. As we grow, there will be many problems, more responsibilities and pressures in our lives. And it is so easy to fall if we do not have that close relationship with our Master. We can be easily blown away by the storms in our lives. How many suicide cases have you read in the news lately, this year? Alarming. During the early part of this pandemic, I must admit, it is easy to let go, to be relaxed in my spiritual life. No church, no Sunday school, no precept class, no pressure, no need to wake up early, no need to prepare lessons. Wow, that is not bad. I still pray a lot. I was worried of what is happening. Every day is still a busy day. All the chores that kept me busy and tired. I neglected my spiritual food. And after a while, I feel empty. Empty. Each day is the same. Work, work, rest, and work again. The reason I'm alive is not just to work. I have to get back. Like the little boy, I must have fallen asleep. I got my precepts book. By the way, precept is a class that I attend every Saturday, which is available in our church. We still continue it now. It's an online class right now, and everyone is free to attend. Okay, so I got my precepts book. Open it to where we stopped because of this pandemic, and my Bible, and I started to do my lessons. God put me back to safety, to read and feel His Word, to be nourished. There's one lady that I know who stopped working because of this pandemic. She has more time now, and she started to read, carefully read her Bible. One chapter a day. To be close to Him is not just a Sunday thing. It is an everyday thing. It is built each day. As I come to a close, I especially want to mention our graduating grade 7 students, Marcus, Tyler Howe, Denise, Janine, Jamie, and Kristen. And to all students who are moving up to another level. We need healthy foods to grow strong, to grow healthy, to grow tall. Our spiritual lives need to be nourished too. We need God's Word, God's presence in us every day. Do not be so relaxed and contented in our spiritual journey. Make the desire to grow in Him stays in us, whatever our age, whatever the circumstances. Bye! Remember, you do not just listen, but it should stay in your heart, in your mind. You digest. Okay? See you!
Dear Lord, as we grow each day, may you help us to also grow in our walk with you. May you help us to spend more time in talking to you, learning from your word, and following your commands. There is much to be worried about in this life, but we know that you are bigger than any of our concerns. Help us to trust in you always. In your precious name we pray. Amen.